doors, you don't have to leave California to find Guantanamo. These prisons here are serious. You have torture going on at the High Desert Prison. They have a place there called Monkey Island where they put the black people for behavior modification experiments. They can know what kind of drugs they give up. You have ecstasy in New York and Village West. You can all go Google this. Four-part investigative report on how police in the Brooklyn precinct are directed to harass African Americans and Spanish to fill their quotas. This is a cop was like Sergio, who went around with a tape recorder and just recorded what he heard at the morning briefings and what he overheard from the cops. That was policy. You know what happened to him? They dragged him away and put him into the asylum, the New York police. Even though he had these tapes, he had the evidence. In Chicago, they just had a torture trial there. You know, I mean, the mayor of Chicago has apologized for torture. And this is, I know in some parts of the country, California especially, Hispanics and African Americans are at each other's throats. I think in Los Angeles, for example, there was one of the largest gang arrests in history that occurred in public housing because Hispanic gangs were trying to get rid of the black. They had the same boat. Matter of fact, Reverend Sharpton said, when the sun goes down, we all Mexicans. Well, Mexicans have a lot of African ancestry.
Right.
I don't know why nobody's informed them of that.
Right.
But at one time, 40% of the population of Mexico City was black. Simón Bolívar was black. He went to Haiti for refuge. The Haitians harbored Simón Bolívar. I mean, you had some of the great leaders in Mexican history. Matt, there was a show there called The Third Root. It was in the 1990s that the Mexican government finally acknowledged an African component in American, Mexican history. So this is something that we can at least make an alliance about, which is police brutality.
Right.
I heard this thing on KPFA the other day where the LAPD, went into this Mexican American middle class home and beat up everybody. And the patriarch of the family, he had diabetes, and they left him in a car for an hour, he needed insulin. I mean, he's up to disgrace. He called him all kind of names. You know, like they call us by the end, where they have names for Mexican Americans. And this is something that's happening all over. And I think that the so-called activists, I listen to KPFB, that's what I've been like. It's a problem. Too bad. I think there's an error in pointing to a few highlight cases. I always hear about police brutality here, Sean Bell, or Amadou Diallo, or Oscar Grant. This stuff is happening all across the country. They murdered a man in New Jersey, a black man who was the CEO of a corporation. A cop shot him in the park. So there goes the argument that the police only harass underclass blacks and they deserve it because of their behavior status. You know, Adrienne Kennedy, one of the great playwrights, had her son beaten up in his front yard by the police. They wrote a play about it. The two of them collaborated on a play about it. I get my hometown newspaper, they're killing black people in Buffalo, New York. The police are. So, I mean, this has become such a problem. They're going out treating Hispanics and blacks anyway. And this is something that has no gender division. They beat up black women and Hispanic women. I wrote this thing about, it's been coming as a surprise, but you know that the biggest substance abuse problem in California is among white women. I don't know if anybody knew this, but you can go Google it. New York Times. You get the jails full of Hispanic and black women for these minor drug violations. So this is disrupting families all across the country. So this is such a nationwide problem. But I think that some of these cops ought to go to the Haiti. You ought to treat them like, why are you just picking on Africa? They got people over here.
That's right.
Do the same thing.
That's right.
Matter of fact, the guy who was in charge of the torture policy at Guantanamo was a former American police official, or a prison official.
And you have this officer in Chicago now who's on trial for the torture of hundreds of black men to elicit false testimony.
And the journalists who, the journalists just like poor Gary Webb, poor guy.
Gary Webb, that's right.
A martyr. Talked about them putting on crack in African American communities and the press, a slut, or we call it a liberal press, jumped all over him, drove him to his death. Mm-hmm. And then finally the CIA comes out, 2 years later, saying, oh yeah, we knew about it, we knew, you know.
Right.
And the 260 page report saying, yeah, we knew that they were putting crack in these communities. So the journalist who exposed the torture cases in Chicago, he can't get a job now. He wrote a play about it, you know. Nobody will hire him. He lost it because he exposed the torture that goes on in Chicago. But it bothers, he said what surprised him. What surprised him was the indifference.
Right.
The attitude of indifference on the part of the general public about the exposure of torture in these prisons. They worried about the Gitmo. The left is worried about the accommodations provided to Bin Laden's chauffeur. You know, we worried about, maybe they're right if Bin Laden came over here and he'd be down in Florida playing golf with OJ. the left seems to be so concerned about what's happening abroad that they can't, any good man can't pay attention to stuff that's happening right in Rikers Island, which is a few miles away from our station. They got to ask the Village Voice about torture and brutality at Rikers Island and right in New York. But the left the left lost its sign when they demonized black men. I know you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Where would the left be in the 60s without Malcolm X, Martin Luther King, Stokely Carmichael? So these new groups come in there and they demonize them. I say, middle class feminists, you don't experiment on us for 20 years. When are you going to go to Broadway? And we're going to go from off-Broadway to, you know, the people who were signing these welfare reform bills, you know, who are putting us in minimum security things, the hours black women in jail. We're going to go up to them. I mean, I'm tired of hearing about OJ and Tiger Woods. Who else talking about Tiger Woods, OJ, Kobe, Michael Vick and them dogs? They care more about them dogs. I don't know about people who have sympathy for pit bulls. I'm sorry. I guess I'm the extra when it comes to that.
But this ties in explicitly with the point that we were making earlier about where we were in a phase in the Cultural Revolution in the 1960s and 70s of analyzing this as a structure, as a system. The fact that the Americas and the United States of America in particular have been founded on the rights of European Americans, so-called white people, to murder blacks with impunity.
Yeah, but they kept them out for a long time, too.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, a lot of the people who are white now weren't white 50 years ago. As a matter of fact, they called the Irish Hibernians. In Boston, they referred to them as a different race. Some of the English students referred to the Irish as a different race. And they had signs out there saying, no Irish people on the Boston Commons. And the solution to the race problem in the 19th century was to have an Irishman kill a black person and get hanged for it, you know. Get it? You know. So they just got in, Italian Americans. They're still arguing whether Italian Americans are white. So these are people who call whites. The Jewish Americans were referred to as Orientals, first part of the last century. So I mean, it's very complicated. But I think the people who founded, who are so-called founders, they just came from a different class than a lot of the people who came here later. People who came here later, matter of fact, your voice went to Russia. Was it Russia you went to and said those people were like a little more than slaves?
Went to Germany and Russia. That's right.
It said they were a little more than slaves. And I'm doing a book on Muhammad Ali that's coming out next year. He's not going to like it.